Hi, KB here with a quick update. As you might have seen, Aquacomputer released the X.47 update for Aquasuite in December 2021. It's a big upgrade with some interesting new functionality. And if you haven't upgraded yet, here's a warning. If you have set up profiles or anything in the notification section in Aquasuite, that will be deleted when you do the upgrade. So make sure to back up your configuration by screenshotting or writing down what you have made so you can recreate your setup afterwards. Let's take a look at the changelog. The last public release was X.44 from August 2021. If we go through what has changed since then, we see quite a few bug fixes, some updates for hardware monitoring, including support for Intel Alder Lake, which is nice, and the new stuff, inputs, outputs, and profiles. And this is a warning, no old settings are applied. It should really be in big red flaming letters, meaning that whatever you had in the profiles or notification sections are not carried over to the new version. Profiles are no longer limited to a maximum of 4, and the functionality on how to automatically switch profiles has changed. I haven't used profile in my setup, so I won't go into the changes here. The old notification section in the playground has been renamed to outputs. It supports the new profiles, but other than that, it doesn't seem to have changed that much on the surface. The new kid on the block is the inputs section in the playground. Inputs are values that you can use directly as data sources in the playground, or you can use them to tweak the fan and RGB controllers. The value of an input can be set by adding controls directly to your desktop or the system tray, so you don't have to launch Aquasuite to adjust how your system acts. As an example, I have a target temperature controller that controls the fan speed to maintain a 40 degrees water temperature. I prefer target temperature controllers over curve controllers since I like to run my fans at idle speed unless cooling is needed, and then only speed up the fans as much as needed to keep the temperature that I've set. To me, that gives me the most pleasing noise profile of my system. Let's add an input to set the target water temperature for the controller. I'll start by adding a new input. I'll call it maximum water temperature. I'll set the unit to degrees Celsius and the precision to 1, so we get 1 decimal precision. I'll set the minimum temperature to 20 degrees and the maximum to 60. The startup I'll set to 40, since that's what I've been using on my controller until now. I'll put a checkmark in the recover last value after restart. Otherwise, the value would be reset to the startup value when my computer restarts. The user controls are the controls visible to the user. A slider is added as a standard. If I put a checkmark in the show in system tray box and go out of full screen mode, I can now see it here. You can add other kinds of controls like dials or input fields as well. Let's show it in the system tray. Very nice. I'll just stick with the slider for now. We can even change the icon. Now that I have my input value, I want to set it as the target temperature in my fan controller. Unfortunately, it is not possible to do that directly. I hope that is something Aquacomputer will add in a future version. I'll give my slider a nice name and correct my spelling mistake here. That way. You can only use the inputs as offsets to scale the output, as we can see here. So what I'll do is add a virtual software sensor to calculate the negative value of my input, since I need to subtract the value from the measured water temperature. I name the controller fan controller offset, and the unit I set to degrees Celsius. And I add my input as a data source. And I simply subtract the input from zero to get the negative value. Select the function, subtraction. 0 minus 40 is minus 40. Back in the fan controller, I can now use my virtual software sensor as an input offset. Fan controller offset. And set my target temperature to zero. That way, if the water temperature is above 40, minus 40 is added to the source value, and the value is still above zero, which we have set as our target. So the controller will speed up the fans to cool down the water. If I change the input value, you can see the input offset reflects the change. And if I drag it below the current water temperature, so you'll see the controller begins to raise the controller output to speed up the fans to cool the water down to whatever I've set. I'll put it back to 40. And the control output is back to zero. This was just one example of how you can use the new inputs. I like to keep my system as autonomous as possible, so I don't think I'll be using them a lot, but your philosophy might be different. In any case, they are a very nice addition to the software. As always, questions and comments are welcome below, and please remember to like and subscribe. Until next time, be happy and have fun.